I'm nervous. Hello, I'm Debbie Goose, and currently I'm writing a novel from beginning to hopefully end here on this channel, documenting the various mistakes, mishaps, and side quests I end up on the way, all whilst putting various writing advice and frameworks to the unscientific test. And today, things get serious. Specifically, today I have one aim: writing a one-sentence premise. That's it. Sounds simple enough, but I think this might be the most challenging thing I've done on this channel. I am looking to follow the Snowflake method in order to create a premise and plot that out along with the main characters. And I initially thought that, you know, this would be a video, Snowflake method. But I think it might end up being a few parts, as today we're just going to be looking at step one. So I'm going to be following the Advanced Fiction Writing blog site's article about the Snowflake method, and its step one definitely left me intrigued. Take an hour, you heard that correct, and write a one sentence summary of your novel. So that's what today's video is. I wanted to actually do this, give this a complete fair shot. Obviously, I think the idea being conveyed here is spend a good chunk of time thinking just about your premise before going on to the next steps. But we are gonna spend an hour exactly writing one sentence, a premise. So if you're new here, I've already done quite a few videos, various attempts of characterization and plotting. We've tried Save the Cat plotting, we've tried the hero's journey plotting. Most recently we did the 27 chapter method. So throughout this I've come up with various different ideas, and it's all ended up increasingly all over the place. So I change my mind and change my mind again and get pulled in different directions as part of fulfilling these different templates, because it probably isn't that advised to give every single template a go for one project. I'm not suggesting you do this. This is just fun. This is just a chance to explore different templates. But I feel like it is a good time to start thinking about bringing it all a little bit back together and working out exactly what the premise is, what I want to do with this project, to then do the next layers of planning and then writing. And as a self-proclaimed pantser, the idea of sitting here and spending an hour thinking about just what my premise is, well, it's certainly not the approach I would usually take. So it certainly ticks the box of trying new things. Now, I don't have an actual clock I can put here. I just have a cute analog clock, which I can't read very easily myself, but I'll be able to use that to show that we are actually following the time. And we are gonna be starting this at 45, 46, 47, 48, 5:48. Let's press go. Okay. You know, how about we read a bit more from the article? So, like I said, the article is by Advanced Fiction Writing. It's actually written by, where is his name? By Randy Ingemanson. And in reference to step one here, Randy writes, okay, take an hour and write a one sentence summary. The sentence will serve you forever as a 10 second selling tool. This is the big picture. When you later write your book proposal, the sentence should appear very early in the proposal. It's the hook, gotta make it interesting, that will sell your book to your editor, to your committee, to the sales force, to bookstore owners, and ultimately to readers. Okay, well, let's be honest between you and me here. I'm doubtful that this particular project will ever end up in that, but you never know. So make the best one you can. Some hints on what makes a good sentence. Shorter is better. Try for fewer than 15 words. All right. 15 words in an hour. We can do this. No character names, please. Better to say a handicapped trapeze artist than Jane Doe. Well, that's good, because I really haven't decided fully on my character names. Tie together the big picture and the personal picture. I think the key kind of things we want to write here. I mean, this is simple. This is big picture stuff. but we want to convey a who. Someone is involved in this and they're wanting something. What are they wanting? What's at stake? I think those are the kind of key kind of ideas we want to get into this 15 words. So far, our story has had, the beginning has pretty much been the same across all of my various variations of the plot. We have a magician. That is the one constant, no matter what various stuff I chuck at it, as a magician. I don't even remember how we started with that. That stems all the way back to Save the Cat, when I was just making stuff up on the spot with no prior ideas coming into it. And that seems to be what stuck. So that's pretty much going to be our who, certainly for this first pass. Our magician character ends up seeking audience with the king of the lands. It's sort of set in like a medieval type kingdom. He seeks audience with the king of the lands, usually because the theater he works at is being shut down or needs financial aid or something like that. So he seeks audience with the king, and it goes terribly wrong when, instead of getting the help for the arts that he was after, he gets arrested for attempting to kill the king. And in my latest rendition, I actually made that a little bit, cut that down a little bit, and had the king be at the performance, the magician's performance, and all's going well until the king volunteers for one of the tricks. And during that trick, things go terribly wrong, and our magician character is blamed and he's arrested, with it suggested that he purposely was trying to kill the king as part of that, and a little bit of mystery there around who framed him and if the king was perhaps involved in trying to frame him. And then from there, that his attempts to prove his innocence and to, you know, go fairly poorly, he has to solve a little bit of why he's being framed, and it all leads to like uncovering a bigger mystery, a bigger conspiracy. And they find out the king's involved in some stuff and needs to be stopped kind of ideas. So let's write a version of that down, and then let's take it from there. Try to put it on the page just as it is, you know, and then we can embellish it. So what I've written is, a magician must prove his innocence after being arrested for attempting to assassinate the king. That's a sentence. I think for one thing, this magician, let's flesh that out a little bit, because we're really not talking about like a fully fledged magician. We're talking about a wannabe magician, an aspiring magician. Or I feel like at the moment he's really working as a magician's assistant, and maybe he's having his first kind of little breaks of getting to do like 10 minutes of the show himself. He's even a magician's protege. He's being trained and is still making a name for himself. It'd be nice just to have like a teeny tiny bit more info right there. It's one extra word, we'll cut a word somewhere else. And then must prove his innocence. Fights to prove his innocence. Thank you, Casper. A magician's protege fights to prove his innocence after a dangerous trick goes horribly wrong. Now, of course, the reason I don't like this is it sounds like one of those YouTube, you'll never believe what happens next will shock you, which is not. I know that we're going for a hook, but we also want to go for, I don't want to go for that type of hook where it's just language being thrown about. I'm not too worried about the whole shorter is better thing at the moment. If I end up with it being longer, and that gives me a clearer idea of what I'm doing, then we'll cut it down. After a dangerous trick goes wrong, and aspiring a magician's, maybe just a young magician, a fledgling magician. Ooh, I like that, a fledgling. Okay, after a dangerous trick goes wrong, a fledgling magician is arrested of attempted assassination with little hope of proving his innocence. I know that that with little hope of proving his innocence is not good. After a dangerous trick goes wrong, a fledgling magician is arrested of attempted assassination. That's nice. You know what? That's actually probably the best I've got so far. But I would like to get a bit more of an action in, conveying that idea that he's going to have to work to try and prove his innocence. I want more of a bit of a, what is he, like, it obviously implies that our character doesn't want to rot in jail, because who would? But what does he have to do? My job is particularly punctual. Okay, that was a side rant, which I will cut out. What next? Let us have a quick look. Okay, I've got 44 minutes remaining here. Okay, the thing is, okay, I think I'm going to write a little bit. Actually, you know what? So let's just have a little think about what I actually want in this story. So one, I do want it to have a historical feel to it. I want to be able to sort of mix and match medieval-esque and maybe like Roman clothing and like mix and match it all a little bit in. We're definitely doing like an alt universe here. I'm interested in almost exploring ideas of, you know how a lot of stories will have a message around it's never okay. You know, like there'll be a situation where there's like clearly a bad option, but it's better. And the story will usually have the moral of no, that's not okay. And some other option will appear, which will be a win-win for everyone. I'm kind of interested in exploring something where that magical win-win doesn't appear. And it is a matter of choosing the lesser of evils. And a lot around living with regret and guilt and those emotions, because they're just so cheerful to explore. And I actually wanted to have a little bit of almost like testing, almost like a trolley problem type thing. You know, maybe like the main 2-1 kind of taking the approach of it's not our place to meddle and leave it up to God. And one taking the approach of, no, let's pull the lever and have less people be killed. I know that's now us actively killing this group over here, and that's bad, but that's less than if we leave it going over the, you know, the one person over there is better than the 5 people over there. So I'm interested in those kind of ideas. We don't necessarily need to get it all into the premise. We just need to get a hinting of it. And I think that hinting comes from he has to work out why he's been framed, and in doing so, learns a terrible secret and has to make an impossible choice. Ooh, I like that. Terrible secret. I mean, that's cliche, just can be, but who cares? And impossible choice. Impossible choice is the idea we're going to get to. Okay, I'm going to read this to you. It's really bad, but it's the first thing my fingers typed out, so I'll read it to you for the sake of honesty. When a fledgling magician is framed for assassination, he must uncover the truth, and in doing so learns a terrible secret and must make an impossible choice. That is not good, but those are the ideas we want to get into 15 words. When a fledgling magician learns a terrible secret, he must make an impossible choice. Well, it suddenly meets word count, but I feel like we have accidentally cut out all of the kind of I feel like the whole framed for assassination is part of the hook. It's part of the interesting bit, you know? Because the rest is too vague to actually be interesting, and that's almost a problem in and of itself. It's always a bit of a balance of premise. You don't want to be giving away the conclusion. You want to be setting up, because the premise is not the conclusion. The premise is not the solution. The premise is the problem. When a fledgling magician is framed for assassination, his attempts to uncover the truth lead to an impossible choice. It's starting to get better. It's not good though. This has never been my strong suit. And I definitely don't thrive of being put on the spot. But you know what? We've still got 35 minutes to keep tweaking this and just keep tweaking it until we end up in a place we actually am happy. Or we don't. And then we put this out as a video anyway and continue to claim that it's okay, that it sucks. It is a truthful example of the creative process. And that's interesting in its own right. It would be nice to make it good though, wouldn't it? Just a little nice to make it good. We'll try. We're gonna try our best here, guys. All right, let's go back to thinking a little bit more about what we can possibly want. I'll include all of these notes, I'll add them to my planning doc and pop them in the description below. All right, I'm just gonna speed this footage up here, but basically I spend a good like 5 minutes talking about our
other main character, Agatha, only to decide that, yeah, she doesn't really fit into the premise at all.
But I think the key things with her is that she helps him escape, that they both find out this secret together, and that she takes an opposing opinion to him as to what to do. That's really where things are going to get juicy there. I feel like her existence would make sense in a one paragraph summary, but maybe not in a one sentence summary. When a fledgling magician is falsely imprisoned, his attempts to prove his innocence lead to an impossible choice. 18 words, so a little bit long. It's not really very hooky. I don't know if that would capture my attention that much, but it is certainly something. I feel like lead to an impossible choice. It's not really an impossible choice. It is a ethical calculation that I really want to be exploring. You know what? I don't actually like his attempts to prove his innocence. I still think we need to get this idea that he's uncovering something. His attempts to prove his innocence uncover an uncomfortable reality and an impossible choice. Uncomfortable is an odd word, I know, but I kind of like it because the kind of idea I'm going for is, yeah, ethically uncomfortable. You're not necessarily doing what's wrong, but you don't want to be doing it, you know? An uncomfortable choice. Actually, that sums it up better than impossible. When a fledgling magician is falsely imprisoned, he must make an uncomfortable choice. I do actually like that, except we are misrepresenting, we're skipping over. It makes it sound like the uncomfortable choice is a direct result of the false imprisonment, which it's not. The false imprisonment leads to an investigation, leading him to learning info and then having to make an uncomfortable choice. But we don't necessarily need those nuances in here. What I do feel, the premise, when a fledgling magician is falsely imprisoned, he must make an uncomfortable choice, really needs is like a little dash in something else. When a fledgling magician is falsely imprisoned, he must make an uncomfortable choice, kill or be killed. You see, that's got some hook to it. Is it a misrepresentation? Technically no, because that is actually what I'm going to be going for. There is going to end up being a thing of being involved in allowing people to be killed, or everyone, including him, be killed. So there is actually going to be a bit of kill or be killed, but not quite in the way that you normally think of that. I'm going to leave it written here. You know, it's not terrible. It does, however, have me thinking about Hunger Games type, Tournaments of the Death type stuff. It's almost as if like the prison system is, okay, he got falsely imprisoned and now he's going to be a fighting in the gladiators arena, because that's what the society does with its prisoners, which isn't at all what I'm going for. How much time do I have left? Okay, 20 minutes, guys. We've got 22 minutes. I feel like we're getting close, though. Okay. I will say the terrible secret's not going to involve aliens. I did some videos where I included aliens. That was just a offshoot, a side quest. It's not going to be aliens. It's going to be something similar. So let me just map that out, because I think the reality is we can't convey all of that in our premise. We just can't. We don't need to. A premise doesn't need to convey all of this. At the moment, though, we're kind of jumping from false imprisonment to impossible choice. So let me just experiment with what some other combinations could look like. So how about, instead of when a fledgling magician is falsely imprisoned, when a fledgling magician stumbles across a kingdom-threatening secret, he must make an impossible choice. An uncomfortable choice. And then, in parenthesis, kill or be killed. Because I haven't decided if I'm going to go with that. That feels a little bit like a Hail Mary of, look, it is interesting, I promise. Look, ooh, death. Stumbles across. That feels like potential. If we adjust that language, maybe we can get some more of these ideas in. When a fledgling, I mean, we don't always have to do when a fledgling magician, we could do something else. A fledgling magician learns a kingdom-threatening secret and must make an uncomfortable choice. Kingdom-threatening danger, kingdom-threatening dilemma, kingdom-threatening choice. Secret is not, it's not doing anything. We already said learns, which implies that it's not widely known. So secret's really not doing anything. A kingdom-threatening force. I know that word's not doing much, but it does suggest that it is some, that it's a danger. We're not talking about secret and like someone had an affair. We're talking about a danger, a dangerous force that's being kept secret. A fledgling magician uncovers a kingdom-threatening force and must make an uncomfortable decision. Uncovers a kingdom-threatening force. I like that. I think that's starting to convey a little bit about what's actually going to be happening. Now, something that I could do here is kingdom-threatening force has already got a little bit of a hook to it, you know? Like, it already conveys that there's going to be some danger. And what's going to be wanted is overcoming this force. We've got to remember, we do actually still want to be conveying some stakes as to what's going to, if things are lost, and what's actually wanted. I think we're doing the stakes there with that. And it does actually mean that maybe that uncomfortable decision isn't necessarily needed. Are we doubling up on the sort of ideas? Do we need to say on our premise this is all going to end up being about ethical dilemmas? I mean, it's not a bad thing to convey. But yeah, let's, again, we'll just try. I feel like a lot of this is we've got, you know, 8 known pieces of info. We're working out what 2 make sense to be in here. A fledgling magician is falsely imprisoned, however, in attempting to prove his innocence, uncovers a kingdom-threatening force. All right, I feel like we are back again at, I like the info being conveyed, but I do not like the words it's being conveyed in. It's not neat and tidy. But falsely imprisoned, trying to prove his innocence, uncovers a kingdom-threatening force. We've got a little bit of the what initially happens, what the catalyst is, what our character's wanting, the stakes involved. We've got some ideas going on, so let's try and shorten this down and neaten it up. His escape attempt leads to uncovering a kingdom-threatening force. We could switch out proving his innocence for attempting to escape. When a falsely imprisoned magician attempts to escape, he uncovers a kingdom-threatening force. Okay. My phone ran out of storage, but hopefully we didn't miss too much. I am somehow looping all the way back to the beginning and forgetting all about this life, the kingdom-threatening force, and just giving a go at just writing the premise about the false imprisonment. So when a performance goes horribly wrong, a fledgling magician is imprisoned for attempted assassination. As a premise goes, it's not too bad, to be honest. And then obviously the paragraph premise will flesh out some of the other ideas. I would, however, like to get into this. If we're gonna go this route, oh my God, we've got 7 minutes left, guys. An hour wasn't long enough. When a fledgling magician is imprisoned for attempting to murder the king, I am just taking everything from the before one and now chucking it at the beginning, before the main verb. When a fledgling magician is imprisoned for attempting to murder the king, he must fight to prove his innocence. So now at least I've got a bit more of an action, what he must do. And I think the stakes are fairly implied. But what I don't like is fight to prove his innocence. I don't, actually don't like fight here. I want, oh, though, fight to prove his innocence does suggest some gladiator stuff, which isn't what we were going for. Maybe we just change what our story is actually going to be and chuck in some, what they do with the convicted criminals is make them fight to the death. Is there a word, a single word, like homicide, but means specifically to murder the king? Regicide. There's a word for it. Of course, there's a word for it. I don't think I can use that word though, because who actually knows it? When a fledgling magician is imprisoned for attempted regicide, I don't think we can do that, even though it cuts down the words. He must fight to prove his innocence. He must fight. Honestly, I think that's the best so far. I feel like a lot of his other ideas just don't fit well into the one sentence premise. They're the consequences coming out of the initial premise. The core catalyst is him getting imprisoned, and what he initially wants is to be deemed innocent and regain his freedom. And he's going to do that, probably not by physically fighting, unless we change the premise of our story, which we could do. But yeah, unless we do that, then yeah, I think the rest comes into the paragraph summary. Unless we can get some sort of idea behind, like, his attempts uncover a nasty truth. When a fledgling magician is imprisoned for attempted regicide, I really can't use that word. I want to use that word. His attempts to prove his innocence uncover a kingdom-threatening truth. Okay, let me just clean this up a tiny little bit. We have hit an hour. It's exactly an hour. I think we got it though. I just give me 5 seconds. All right, I think we've got it, guys. Literally on the wire, past the wire, 15 words exactly. Kept the clock going though, so you can see I'm only like a minute past the wire. When a fledgling magician is falsely imprisoned, his attempts to escape uncover a kingdom-threatening truth. I mean, obviously we haven't got too much of what he wants. I feel like reading between the lines, we've got what he wants. He wants to escape and also possibly overcoming this kingdom-threatening issue. I feel it's good enough. I don't know if it's good enough. I feel it's good enough for today.
All right. Hello. Excuse me for looking a mess. It is 10:45 p.m. I am in bed editing. I think it's about 4 days after I filmed it, so very outside of that hour period I gave myself. But I think I've done it. I think I have worked out what I want the premise to be. When an aspiring magician is arrested for treason, escape will test his every moral fiber. 15 words exactly. And yeah, something has clicked. I think I might have got to the bottom of what the evil things going on are really about, and exactly what it is I want to do with this story. So more to come, but that's your little preview of where things are heading. Oh, and the aliens, they might be back. Good night.